Good morning, Leos. Welcome to Kiki's Doorway. Let's see what your past life wants you to revisit for July 18th to July 25th, 2018. Last week you were the transporters of your destination and where you want to go in your life, in the type of relationships that you want to start partaking in the way that you see fit, and in the enjoyment of life and traveling to the places that give you inner and outer peace, harmony, and recognition of self. So let's see what you want to revisit from your past life. God, Gaia, God, Goddess, Mother, Father. What does Leo's past life want them to revisit? Okay, you have two, okay. This is going to be interesting. You're the first to have two cards. What action will Leos take on July 18th to July 25th? Be fitting to have two cards come. two, huh? You getting all your four corners, your air, fire, water, and earth, huh? I feel you. So let's see what your past life wants you to revisit. Okay. Now that you have traveled to your destinations and discovered more about yourself and people, places, and things around you, your past life wants you to revisit that you have always traveled to and from. If you had to leave, it was shedding or leaving things that didn't serve the purpose for your next destination. Yet you held tricklets of the essence of what you have learned before you traveled. You always keep the lessons in the blessing of life. You, Mr. and Ms. Leos, understand that life happens to us once in this skin, in this shape. And in order for us to know ourselves, our bodies must leave, go to the next destination. Our mind must advance to learn more. Our hearts wants to feel, so it had to leave or change the environment to know more emotion or a new emotion to find a way to love it unconditionally. So let's find out. Mr. and Ms. Leos, what your past life wants you to know through Dorian Virtue interpretation. Okay. Leave or travel. Mr. and Ms. Leos, you drew this card because of an old pattern spanning several lifetimes that involves travel and leaving. You may notice in this lifetime that you are a vagabond of sorts and want to continually be moving. You may wish to travel often or seek out a career in which you do so. You may also tend to move to new homes frequently. You developed This propensity, propensity for leaving and movement out of necessity during your lives as a Bedouin or other type of nomad. Your relationships may have also involved you leaving your partner or being left by a partner who traveled. This kind of movement is impacting the situation that you are inquiring about today. So, if you are concerned about things leaving you, ask yourself, what causes you the concernment if you, in fact, Mr. and Ms. Leos, have that same essence to leave and travel yourself? Out of all people, the person might feel your energy of understanding that. Yet understanding consciously but not directly talking about it can leave a gap to a person to fill in like a story, to assume what should be in that paragraph. If you are concerned about relationships, intimate relationships, I really had to think about that one, because that one seemed to really come into my mind's eye heavily for you, Mr. and Ms. Leos. If you're concerned about intimate relationships when it comes to leaving or traveling towards something that you might not resonate with or connect to yet, understand that you are Leos, that you are the heart of us. A person wouldn't feel right within themselves to abandon you without feeling confident that you are strong for both of you, with or without them. You give them the strength to become them best, their best self. And if that means for that particular person to show their Leo side of self to you, to show their loyalty or dedication to you, then so be it. Or to show that in order to have a real union with a person, sometimes you must show them elements of yourself that you didn't even know you had. Like, for example, I'm a Taurus. So the reason why I really chose to do Kiki's Doorway is to better understand not just myself, but other people through the zodiac, through their birth chart, through their numbers of when they were born, and their name itself. This will help me to not, I felt the need to go in that path because for a long time I didn't understand how people interact, including myself, when I engage in others. And I noticed based on my sign being a Taurus, and at moments, I notice a lot of times I would use my opposite sign, which is Scorpio, to even out my emotions because I'm so fixed that at times I have to find a smooth, nurturing, or intuitive approach to myself or people, places, and things. So it goes back to you, Leos. Whoever you are intimately engaged with or you have a connection with, a soul connection with, understand that sometimes it takes separation to binds a union strongly, like a rubber band. You can only stretch that rubber band for so far, yet it's strong enough to go right back into its original shape. Your past life also wants you to know that heart of the lion, that intimacy that you have, is connected to knighthood. A lot of people may not know, or they do have that feeling of knowing of your energy when you are around them, not just of your loyalty, but of your intuition of knowing how to exude real, raw love, unconditional love, and stand in truth with that, so much so that you became a knight to protect your loved one as an individual and as a community. So when I felt in my mind's eye to say that your partner felt that out of all people, out of all zodiacs that they have encountered before they even met you, that you have a degree that of not just of a lion, but of Scorpio, number 8. You have the scales, you're very logical. You know how to be nurturing, but how to pull off like a Gemini and bring stability in communicating. And if the communication is dull to your standard, you definitely know how to spice it up with that Aries or Sagittarius side of yourself. The horse, number 9. You have from 9 all the way down to 1. Sagittarius, Scorpio, Libra, Virgo, you, Leo, Cancer, Gemini, Taurus, and Aries. You have all the 9 elements with you. So know that, just like a knight, no knight is going to just have some random lover. They're going to have a noble person, noble at heart, light as a feather, like the Egyptians say. So when they come back to you, they'll come back as their best self, as their full self that you always knew they would be. The actions you're going to take on July 18th to July 25th, you are the star. You are the star that lights the way for others to be their knightly self. Archangel Raphael wants you to know that, see, like the cups, like the Libra scales, you hold the emotions, you hold the abundance of Cancer, the adventurous side of Pisces. You have the earth elements with you, air, and even the ethers, the star. Happy times make positive, optimistic, long-term plans on the right path. See, you're on the right path, and your partner's on the right path as well. You may not see it, but just like a knight, do you see their moves all the time? No. And 11. Ah. Wow. Wow. Strength in the star. Look at that. And what? Ew. Tiger. Lion. And you got your shield, your armor. I felt that with the Gemini presence in the air. Archangel Ariel. Great inner strength. Release harsh judgments. Forgiveness and compassion. Have forgiveness for your partner. When you do that, I'm telling you, I had to go through that recently with someone I care about. you have to release your desire and your hopes. And this a lack of disappointment of not knowing, to know that you already know what they're trying to be and who you're trying to be at the same time. They wouldn't move if you're not moving, right? So no, when you do that, compassion will come immediately. Immediately. So until we meet again, Mr. and Miss Leos, you have intuition on your side. You have Aquarius on your side. You have from not only 9, but you jumped up 11. You are tapping into your Aquarius side of self. And when you do that, we are in the year of Aquarius. You are your best self at this very moment. And whoever is in your life right now, trust. They are making moves so they could be their best self. If not, you have the strength to go towards people that know your self-worth and know your knighthood of self. Till we meet again, Mr. and Ms. Leos, I love you. And we will see you on the other side.